All three Kassapa brothers were ordained, along with their 1,000 followers. And so, the Buddha gained 1,003 newly ordained monks. When he saw that they were all ready and eager to listen to his Dhamma, he gave the Adittapariyaya Sutta, the fire sermon. The Buddha taught that all things are aflame. The eyes are aflame. The ears are aflame. The nose is aflame. The mouth is aflame. Touch is aflame. The mind is aflame. What is this fire that is aflame within us? It is the flame of raka, desire. It is the flame of tosa, anger. It is the flame of moha, delusion. It is a flame due to birth, due to the pain and suffering that come from birth, due to the attachments and stress that come from birth. It is a flame due to aging, due to the pain and suffering that come from aging, due to the attachments and stress that come from aging. It is a flame due to death, due to the pain and suffering that come from death, due to the attachments and stress that come from death. All things are aflame with birth, old age, sickness, and death. A flame due to sorrows and lamentations. A flame due to the pain and discomfort of our bodies. A flame due to the discomfort, distresses, despairs, and the suffering of our minds. The well-instructed disciple of the noble ones grows disenchanted. The disciple is disenchanted with the eyes and the things they see. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. They are disenchanted with the ears and the things they hear. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. They are disenchanted by the nose and the smells it smells. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. They are disenchanted by the tongue and the tastes it tastes. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. They are disenchanted by the body and tactile sensation. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. The disciple is disenchanted by the mind and its thoughts and feelings. They see things as merely what they are, a flame. Disenchanted, they become dispassionate. Through dispassion, they are fully released. With full release, there is the knowledge that arises. Fully released. he knows that birth is ended, the holy life fulfilled, the task done. There is nothing further for this world. All the monks listening to the Buddha's fire sermon listened with mindful wisdom. They contemplated as the Buddha taught and used their personal experiences to prove each statement true. Each statement led to more awareness, realization, and acceptance of the truth as it exists in the world. Through their knowledge and experience, they were able to fully grasp the totality of the truth the Buddha taught. Uruvela Kassapa, Nari Kassapa, Gaya Kassapa, and their 1,000 followers all internalized the Buddha's teachings and felt disenchanted. Through their disenchantment, they felt true dispassion. Through dispassion, they felt full release. With full release, they all knew the knowledge that they were fully released. They all knew that for them, birth is ended. Their holy lives have been completely fulfilled. The task was done. They had nothing further for this world. They were all arahants, just like the Buddha. They were no longer under the power of raka, desire, tosa, anger, or moha, delusion. They were free, finally free, never to be reborn again.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.